Welcome to Fenius again. Today we'll discuss real and nominal accounts. In today's video, we'll discuss the definition of real and nominal accounts with examples, what is the accounting treatment of such accounts, and what is the basic difference in real and nominal accounts. But before we move forward, kindly subscribe to my channel Fenius and press the bell icon for the notification of new videos. So let's start today's discussion with the definition of real and nominal accounts. What is a real account? A real account is an account that is not closed at the end of accounting year. As a result, a real account begins each accounting year with its balance from the end of the previous year. Because the end of the year balance is carried forward to the next accounting year, a real account is also known as a permanent account. So what are the examples of real accounts? The real accounts are the balance sheet accounts, such as the account for recording assets, liabilities, or the owner's equity. However, kindly note that the sole proprietor drawing account, which is reported on the balance sheet during the year, is temporary because it is closed directly to the owner's capital account at the end of the year. Now let's see what is a nominal account. A nominal account is an account that is closed at the end of the accounting year. As a result, a nominal account begins each accounting year with a zero balance. Since the balance does not carry forward to the next accounting year, a nominal account is also referred to as a temporary account. Examples of nominal accounts are the income statement accounts, such as the account for recording revenues, expenses, gain and losses. Kindly note that when the income statement accounts are closed at the end of the accounting year, the net amount will ultimately end up in a balance sheet equity account. Now the question comes to your mind is that what is the accounting treatment for real and nominal accounts? So the answer is, to learn the accounting treatment of such accounts, kindly watch my video Double Entry Accounting System and Debit and Credit by Dr. IOC, in which I have explained in detail the rules of debit and credit and shared two tricks to remember the rules of debit and credit, which is very helpful for students. The link to the video is given in the description of this video below. So now, if I'll summarize today's discussion, the main differences of real and nominal accounts are: first, in terms of nature, a real account is considered as a permanent account, whereas a nominal account is considered as a temporary account. In terms of accounting type, assets, liabilities, and equity accounts are considered as real accounts, whereas revenue and expenses are considered as nominal account. What is the time of closing such accounts? So remember, real accounts kept open and balances are carried forward to the next accounting year, whereas nominal accounts are closed at the end of each accounting year. In terms of financial statement use, real accounts are used in balance sheet or statement of financial position. For this reason, they are called balance sheet items, whereas nominal accounts are used in income statement and they are called income statement items. What is the objective of a real account and a nominal account? The objective of real account is to determine the financial position of the business, whereas the objective of a nominal account is to determine the annual net profitability or the loss of the business. I hope you have understood the difference between real and nominal account. That's it from my side. If you have any query, you can write in the comment section below. I'll try my level best to answer your query. Till the next video, take care. Bye.